हेलो माय डियर एंथुजियास्टिक फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल केमिस्ट्री इज ऑसम। फ्रेंड्स, इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ हैलोजन डेरिवेटिव्स ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन्स इन डिटेल एंड आई हैव गिवन सम सीईटी और नीट बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस for your practice. In this lecture, we will discuss those CET or NEET based questions. Now let us see what are these questions. Neoamyl iodide is an example of dash dash monohaloalkane. Neoamyl iodide is an example of dash dash monohaloalkane. Neoamyl iodide. Amyl is also called as pentyl. Pent represents how many carbon atoms? 5. Therefore, how to derive structure? Out of 5 carbon atoms, 3 carbon atoms are present in a longest continuous chain and 2 methyl groups are in branches on last but one carbon atom. Since we have to draw structure of new amyl group. Therefore, structure is like this, CH3. Single bond C, branch CH3, branch CH3, single bond CH2, bond I. This is formula for new amyl iodide. Now, we have to find out what type of alkyl halide this is. Since in this halogen atom is bonded to a primary carbon atom. Monohaloalkane is nothing but alkyl halide. Iodine atom is bonded to a primary carbon atom because this carbon atom is bonded to only one another carbon atom. That's why this is referred as primary carbon atom. And to this primary carbon atom, iodine atom is bonded. That's why this is an example of primary alkyl halide. This is an example of primary alkyl halide, or we can say according to question, primary monohaloalkane. Now what is next? Vinyl chloride is classified as. Vinyl chloride is classified as. Here we must able to draw structure of vinyl chloride. Then and then only we can identify whether this vinyl chloride is haloalkyne, haloalkane, halo alkene or halo arene. Now let us see structure of vinyl group. Vinyl group is represented as CH2 double bond CH. Here to this carbon atom, chlorine atom is bonded. Now let us see this example. In this example, there is carbon-carbon double bond, and we know that carbon-carbon double bond is present in case of alkene. Therefore, this vinyl chloride is considered as halo derivative of alkene, or this is nothing but haloalkene. What is name? Vinyl chloride. This is specific name for this compound. But in general, this example belongs to haloalkene. Okay. Now let us see next. Number 3. 2-bromo-3-methylpentane belong to dash dash alkyl halide. 2-bromo-3-methylpentane belong to dash dash alkyl halide. Primary options are primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. 2-bromo-3-methylpentane. What is structural formula for 2-bromo-3-methylpentane? CH3, single bond CH, bond Br. Single bond CH, branch CH3, single bond CH2, single bond CH3. Pentane, longest continuous chain contains 5 carbon atoms. Here substituent halogen atom is present on carbon number 2. Carbon atoms of this longest chain are numbered like this. Therefore, this is formula for 2-bromo-3-methylpentane. Now let us see this carbon atom. Since this carbon atom is bonded to two other carbon atoms, 1 and 3, this is referred as 2 degree carbon atom, secondary carbon atom. And to this secondary carbon atom, bromine atom is bonded. That's why this is an example of secondary alkyl halide. 2-bromo-3-methyl-pentane is an example of secondary alkyl halide. Now let us see next one. This is informative question. Chloroform was used as an dash dash. Chloroform was used as an anesthetic agent. What are the options? Antiseptic, A. B. Anesthetic, C. Analgesic, and D. Antipyretic. Chloroform was used as an anesthetic agent in surgical operations. This is the use of chloroform. Already in discussion of classification, we have given uses of some of the compounds. Chloroform was used as an anesthetic agent in surgical operations. Well, let us see next. Number 5. In bromoethane, the halogen atom is bonded to dash dash hybridized carbon atom. In bromoethane, the halogen atom is bonded to a dash dash hybridized carbon atom, bromoethane. Since suffix is YNE and prefix is eth, that's why this is two carbon compounds. Since there is YNE, we have to put triple bond between two carbon atoms, because we know that suffix YNE represents carbon-carbon triple bond. Bromoethyl, we must attach Br. Now valency of this carbon atom are satisfied. We know that carbon atom is having valency 4. Out of 4 valency, 3 valencies are satisfied by triple bond. 1 valency is satisfied by this carbon bromine single bond. Now to this carbon atom, we have to attach one hydrogen atom. This is formula for bromoethane or bromoacetylene. Bromoacetylene, this is common name, and bromoethane, this is IUPAC name. Now let us say hybridization of this carbon atom. ESP3, what are the options? A. ESP3, B. ESP2, C. ESP, and last D. D2SP3. Already we have discussed types of hybridization of carbon atoms in classification. Now let us see. We know that whenever compound contains triple bond between two atoms, in this triple bond one bond is sigma and remaining two bonds are pi bonds. This is sigma bond. This is also sigma bond. Sigma bond is nothing but single bond. And in this triple bond, out of these three bonds, one bond is sigma bond, that means single bond, and two bonds are pi bonds. Whenever carbon atom form two sigma bonds and two pi bonds, that carbon atom is sp hybridized. That carbon atom is sp hybridized. And what is question here? In bromoethane or bromoacetylene, halogen atom, here halogen atom is bromine atom, is bonded to sp hybridized carbon atom. Sp hybridized carbon atom. Now let us say next one, number 6. Which of the following is used as an antiseptic? Again, this is informative question. You have to remember uses. Iodoform is used as an antiseptic agent. What is antiseptic agent, or what are antiseptics? The substance or substances which can be safely applied on living tissues, to kill or to prevent the growth of microorganisms are called antiseptics or antiseptic agent. And this iodoform powder is used as an antiseptic agent on wound or diseased skin surfaces. Okay. But try to remember one important point. Antiseptic action of iodoform is due to liberation of iodine and not iodoform itself. This is a very, very important point. Antiseptic action of iodoform is due to liberation of iodine and not iodoform itself. When this iodoform powder is applied on skin matter, on skin, surfaces, this iodoform comes in contact with skin and decomposition of this iodoform takes place so that iodine is liberated, and this iodine is having antiseptic action. Therefore, iodoform is used as an antiseptic agent. Now let us see next. Ethylidene dichloride is an example of, now try to remember, read all options carefully. This is very, very important point while solving CET and NEET questions. Which of the ethylidene dichloride is an example of option A, geminal dialyte, B, vicinal dialyte, C, isolated dialyte, and last, terminal geminal dialyte. Now let us see structure or formula for ethylidene dichloride. Ethylidene dichloride, CH3, single bond C, bond H, since suffix is lidine. That's why two chlorine atoms are bonded to same carbon atom. This is formula for ethylidene dichloride. Or according to IUPAC name system, this is also called as 1,1,1 dichloroethane, since there are two carbon atoms, 1,1,1 dichloroethane or ethylidene dichloride. No doubt, this is an example of geminal dialyte, but more specific, this is an example of terminal or we can say primary geminal dialytes, because who knows, geminal dialytes are further classified as primary or terminal geminal dialytes and secondary or non-terminal geminal dialytes. Therefore, what is more specific answer in this? More specific answer is terminal geminal dialyte and not simply geminal dialyte, option A. So they try to remember one important point, read all options carefully and sort out correct option, so that here correct option is last, terminal geminal dialyte. Now let us see next. Question number 8. Which of the following belongs to the isolated dihalide? Isolated dihalide. We know that what are isolated dihalides. In isolated dihalides, halogen atoms are neither bonded to same carbon atom nor bonded to adjacent carbon atoms. They are present on different carbon atoms. Now what are the examples? Ethylene dichloride. Ethylene dichloride formula is CH2Cl, single bond CH2Cl. This is also called as 1,2 dichloroethane, an example of vicinal dialyte. What is next? 1,3 dibromo butane. 1,3 dibromo butane. 1,3 dibromo butane. What is structural formula for 1,3 dibromo butane? Butane CH3, LCH2 bond Cl, single bond CH2, single bond CH, bond Cl, and single bond CH3. If this carbon atom is numbered as 1, numbering should be started from that end, which is nearest to the halogen atom. 1, 2, 3, and 4. This is formula for 1,3 dichlorobutane. Or here, in place of butane, bromine atoms are given. Sorry, here we have to attach bromine atoms. 1,3 dibromobutane. Now what is next? 1,2 dichloropropane. Again, positions are successive in this option C. One chlorine atom is bonded to carbon number first, second chlorine atom is bonded to carbon number second. Total there are three carbon atoms, so that structure becomes like this: CH3, single bond CHCl, single bond CH2Cl. Positions of halogen atoms are successive, or we can say vicinal. Therefore, this is an example of vicinal dialyte. And 1,1 dichloroethane. 1,1 dichloroethane is on the board. This is an example of geminal dialyte. Here we have to find out an example of isolated dihalide. Isolated dihalide is this example. What is the name of this example? 1,3 dibromobutane. Because halogen atoms, that means bromine atoms, are neither bonded to same carbon atom nor bonded to adjacent carbon atoms or successive carbon atoms. Halogen atoms are present on different carbon atoms. That's why this is an example of isolated dihalide. Now what is next question? In haloarenes, halogen atom is bonded to a dash dash hybridized carbon atom. We know that structure of haloarene. Benzene ring is there. To this benzene ring, halogen atom is bonded. Maybe chlorine atom, bromine atom, or iodine atom. So let us see hybridization of this carbon atom. Whenever carbon atom form three sigma bonds, we know that in this double bond, there is one sigma bond and one bond is pi bond. Therefore, whenever carbon atom form three sigma bonds and one pi bond, then hybridization of this carbon atom or that carbon atom is sp2. Hybridization of that carbon atom is sp2. If carbon atom form how many sigma bonds? Three sigma bonds and one pi bond. Hybridization of that carbon atom is sp2. Now what is next? Propionyl bromide belongs to the dash dash class. Propionyl bromide belongs to dash dash class. Propionyl bromide, what is formula for propionyl bromide? CH. Here C, H3, single bond C, triple bond C. Here H is replaced by Br. This is called as propionyl bromide. Propionyl bromide belongs to the class A haloalkene, B haloalkane, C haloalkyne, and D haloarene. We know that here there is triple bond. What is IUPAC name of this compound? IUPAC name of this compound is here 1, 2, and 3. 1 bromopropyl. Therefore, this propionyl bromide, this is common name. 1 bromopropyl is IUPAC name since suffix is YNE and YNE represents triple bond. That's why this example belongs to the class haloalkyne. Very, very simple. But here, you must able to draw structure first and then only you can identify this. Okay. Now let us see next. Number 11, a gas used for refrigeration and air conditioning. This is also informative question. You have to remember uses. That is nothing but CCl2F2. This CCl2F2 is called as difluoromethane according to IUPAC name system. Difluoromethane, commonly known as freon gas, and this freon gas is used for refrigeration and air conditioning. What is next? Propylene diiodide is dash dash 1,1 dihaloalkane, 1,3 dihaloalkane, 1,2 dihaloalkane, and D dihaloalkane. No doubt it is dihaloalkane, but whether it is 1,1 dihaloalkane, 1,3 dihaloalkane, or 1,2 dihaloalkane, this you have to identify so that we must write structural formula for this propylene diiodide. Propylene diiodide can be represented like this: CH3 single bond CH, bond I single bond CH2 bond I. This is propylene diiodide. Now let us see positions of iodine atoms on carbon. This is carbon. This carbon atom is numbered as 1. This is 2nd. This is 3rd. So there, what are the positions? Positions are 1 and 2. Therefore this is 1,2 dihaloalkane. Option C is correct. 1,2 dihaloalkane. Now what is next? Number 13. 3-bromo-3-ethylhexane is classified as dash dash alkyl halide. Again, we have to identify whether it is primary, secondary, tertiary, or quaternary alkyl halide. 3-bromo-3-ethylhexane. 3-bromo-3-ethylhexane. Hexane, how many carbon atoms are there? 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. To this carbon number 3. Bromine atom is bonded, and again to this carbon number 3, ethyl group is also bonded C2H5. And now to satisfy valences of all carbon atoms, simply we have to join hydrogen atoms CH3 CH2. There is no need to join any hydrogen atom because all four valences are already satisfied. CH2 CH2, single bond CH3. Now let us say this carbon atom to which bromine atom is bonded. This carbon atom is bonded to three other carbon atoms, 1, 2 and 3. Therefore, this is tertiary carbon atom. And to this tertiary carbon atom, bromine atom is bonded. That's why this is an example of tertiary alkyl halide. Next, tertiary amyl iodide. Tertiary amyl, we know that. In very first question, we have discussed this. Amyl means pentyl. Tertiary amyl iodide is, here we have to identify its IUPAC name, and that's why first we must able to draw structural formula of tertiary amyl iodide. Amyl is nothing but pentyl. Now let us see at the board. CH3, single bond C, branch CH3, here bond CH2, single bond CH3. And to this tertiary carbon atom, iodine atom is bonded. This is formula for tertiary amyl iodide or tertiary pentyl iodide. Amyl is also called as pentyl. Now let us see, total there are how many carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That's why this is pentyl or amyl. And why tertiary? To this tertiary carbon atom, halogen atom is bonded. That's why name of this compound is tertiary amyl iodide or tertiary pentyl iodide. Now what is its IUPAC name? Numbering should be started from this carbon atom. This carbon atom, because this carbon atom is nearest to halogen atom, or halogen atom is nearest to this carbon atom. This is numbered as 1, this is numbered as 2, this is 3rd and this is 4. So that longest continuous chain contains how many carbon atoms? 4 carbon atoms. Therefore, what is parent alkane? Parent alkane is butane. What about its IUPAC name? 2-iodo-2-methyl-butane. 2-iodo-2-methyl-butane. Now, what is this option? 2-iodo-2-methyl-butane. Option C is correct. 2-iodo-2-methyl-butane. Which of the following, last one, which of the following on alkaline hydrolysis offers diols or glycols? Which of the following on alkaline hydrolysis offers diols or glycols? What are diols or glycols? Diols or glycols are nothing but dihydric alcohols. Di represents 2 and hydric represents hydroxyl groups. Alcohols which contains 2 hydroxyl groups are called as dihydric alcohols or diols or glycols. They are called as glycols because of sweet taste. Now let us see structural formula for this. Which of the following on alkaline hydrolysis offers diols or glycols? Dear friends, remember that primary geminal dialytes on alkaline hydrolysis produces aldehydes. Secondary geminal dialytes on alkaline hydrolysis produces ketones. Alkyl-leading dialytes, that means again halogen atoms are bonded to same carbon atom. Whenever halogen atoms are bonded to same carbon atom, such compounds on alkaline hydrolysis produces either aldehydes or ketones. Now what is one of the option? Option C is correct here. Alkylene dialytes are nothing but vicinal dialytes. Take one example, then you can very easily understand this. CH3, single bond CH, bond Cl. Single bond CH2, bond Cl. This is called as propylene dichloride. Propylene dichloride. This propylene dichloride, when this is hydrolyzed with the help of alkali. What is alkaline hydrolysis? We have to hydrolyze this compound by using aqueous alkali. What are the examples of alkalis? Sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. These are the examples of alkalis. So that for this hydrolysis, we have to take two molecules of KOH or NaOH. On arrow condition is aqueous. That means medium is water. Both these chlorine atoms are replaced by hydroxyl groups. hydroxyl groups from potassium hydroxide replaces these two chlorine atoms, so that there is a formation of compound like this CH3 single bond CH. Now here we have to attach OH because Cl is replaced by OH. Here also Cl is replaced by OH plus. Now let us see byproducts. Two potassium are free and these two chlorine atoms becomes free whenever there is breaking of carbon to chlorine bonds. These two chlorine atoms combines with two potassium, so that there is a formation of two molecules of KCl. Now let us see. This is an example of dihydric alcohol. Why this is an example of dihydric alcohol? Because there are two hydroxyl groups and these dihydric alcohols are also called as diols or glycols. Therefore, what is correct option here? C, alkylene dihalides, because this is an example of alkylene dihalides. Alkylene dihalides on hydrolysis with the help of alkalis such as KOH or NaOH in aqueous medium on heating produces dihydric alcohols or glycols or diols. These are the all your NEET or CET based questions. Now let us see one more question. In N alkyl halides, iso alkyl halides and new alkyl halides, halogen atom is bonded to a dash dash carbon atom. What is question? In N alkyl halides, iso alkyl halides and new alkyl halides, halogen atom is bonded to a dash dash carbon atom. What are the options? Primary, secondary, tertiary or quaternary. These are the options. N alkyl halide means what? In N alkyl halides, halogen atom is bonded to a normal chain of carbon atom. N stands for normal chain. And in normal chain, all carbon atoms are present in only one chain. There is no any carbon atom in branch. Such a chain of carbon atoms is called as normal carbon chain. And at terminal carbon atom, halogen atom is bonded. Say for example, N propyl chloride, N butyl bromide, N pentyl iodide, all these are normal alkyl halides. In all these, halogen atom is bonded to a primary carbon atom. What about isoalkyl halides? In isoalkyl halides, except isopropyl halide, this is option, this is exceptional case. In isoalkyl halides, except isopropyl halide, halogen atom is bonded to a primary carbon atom again. Say for example, isobutyl chloride. What is structural formula for isobutyl chloride? Isopentyl chloride. Isobutyl chloride can be represented like this. CH3 single bond, CH branch, CH3 single bond, CH2 bond, Cl. Isopentyl bromide structure like this. CH3 single bond, CH branch, CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH2 bond, Br. Now let us see. Halogen atom is bonded to this carbon atom and this carbon atom is 1 degree. This carbon atom is also 1 degree. Therefore, in case of isoalkyl halides also, except isopropyl halide, halogen atom is bonded to a primary carbon atom. Halogen atom is bonded to a primary carbon atom. While in isopropyl halide, halogen atom is bonded to a secondary carbon atom. Now let us see structural formula for isopropyl halide. CH3 single bond CH. Here bond Cl single bond CH3. This is isopropyl chloride. You can take Br, you can take iodine also. In isopropyl chloride, isopropyl bromide or isopropyl iodide, halogen atom is bonded to a secondary carbon atom. Why secondary carbon atom? Because this carbon atom is bonded to other two carbon atoms. That's why this is secondary carbon atom. And to this secondary carbon atom, halogen atom or here chlorine atom is bonded. That's why this is only the case in which halogen atom is bonded to a secondary carbon atom. In case of other isoalkyl halides such as isobutyl chloride, isopentyl bromide, isohexyl iodide, isoheptyl bromide, in all these halogen atom is always bonded to a primary carbon atom. And what about new alkyl halides? in case of new alkylalides. Again, halogen atom is bonded to a primary carbon atom. Say for example, take two examples. First one is new pentyl, CH3 single bond C, branch CH3, branch CH3, single bond CH2, single bond I. This is called as new pentyl iodide or new amyl iodide. Next, take next example, CH3 single bond C, branch CH3, single bond CH2, single bond CH2, single bond Br. This is called as new hexyl. Why hexyl? Because total carbon atoms are 6. Why new? Because two methyl groups are in branches on last but one carbon atom. On last but one. This is last but one. Or we can say second last carbon atom. So that in case of new alkyl groups, two methyl groups are in branches on last but one carbon atom or second last carbon atom. Now let us say position of halogen atom. Halogen atom is bonded to this carbon atom and this carbon atom is a primary carbon atom. This carbon atom is also a primary carbon atom because this carbon atom is bonded to only one other carbon atom. And this carbon atom is also bonded to only one other carbon atom. Therefore, both these carbon atoms are primary. Since in both these cases, halogen atoms are bonded to a primary carbon atom. That's why these are the examples of primary alkyl halides. Therefore, try to remember this point also. This is also very, very important point. In N-alkyl halides, in isoalkyl halides except isopropyl halide and new alkyl halides, halogen atom is always bonded to a primary carbon atom. While in case of isopropyl halide, halogen atom is bonded to a secondary carbon atom. Halogen atom is bonded to a secondary carbon atom. Okay, dear students, today we'll stop here. Thank you very much for watching our video. If you have any difficulty or any suggestions, put your suggestions in comment box. We welcome your difficulties all the time. Thank you very much.